Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over five different substrings in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So a substring is a way to return a part of a longer string. And in this case, we have five different strings. One for January, one for February, one for March, one for MyExcelOnline, and one for Mississippi. So the first function we are going to show you is what is known as the left function. And what the left function does is it takes the leftmost part of a string that you may be looking at. So if I type in A2 and I type equals left with a left parenthesis, so the first argument I'm being asked for is where is the text coming from where I want to get my characters? And for now, let's say this cell up here in A1 where it says January. I'm just going to click that and type a comma. And then I say I would like the left most three characters. So I'm going to type in the number 3. Close my parenthesis and hit enter. I can see that I'm returned with J-A-N, which is the first or the leftmost three letters of January. So just like the left function, there is also a function called right. So if I type equals right and a left parenthesis, my first argument I'm being asked for is what text do I want the rightmost characters from? So I'm going to click on the cell right here that says February, and then I'm going to type a comma and type 5 because I want 5 characters. Close my parenthesis and hit enter. And I can now see that I'm returned with the rightmost 5 characters, R-U-A-R-Y.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So the third string function I would like to show you is one that's called mid. So if I go to C2 and I type equals and I type M-I-D with a left parenthesis, again, my first argument is where is the text that I want to take out a substring from? And I'm going to click on C1 and then I'm going to type a comma. But I have two arguments this time instead of one, like with the left and the right. So the first one is start number. And this is what character place am I going to start wanting to take the middle of the word? So in this case, let's just say 2. I want to start at the second position, and then I'm going to type a comma. Next, I'm asked for the number of characters after that starting position. So in this case, I'm just going to say 3, close my parentheses, and hit enter. And now I can see I'm being returned with ARC. I went not the first character in March, not the M, but the second character, which is the A, for 3 characters, ARC, and then that is the end of my mid string. I'm going to click in D2 and show you our next substring function, which is called find. So if I type equals and the word find and a left parenthesis, and my first argument is which text do I want to find in a larger substring? So in this case, because I'm entering text, I'm going to want to open that up with a double quote. And I'm going to type the word Excel. And then I'm going to close my double quotes. Now, one thing that's important to keep in mind is that this argument is case sensitive. So if I put in lowercase excel, I'm probably going to get an error, and I will show you that in a minute. But in this case, I want to match the uppercase Excel because I'm going to be looking for that in the cell that I indicate in the next argument. So if I type a comma, the next argument I need to enter is within text. So where am I looking for this word Excel? So I'm going to click in D1 right here close my parentheses, and hit enter. And I'm going to be returned with a 3. And what the 3 means is that that string was found not in the first place, not in the M, not in the Y, which is the second place, but it began in the third place right here with the EXCEL. Now, if I click back in here and go up here to the formula bar and I backspace and put a lowercase e and hit enter, I will be returned with an error because it is case sensitive when you are using the find function. So if I click back here, go back to a capital E and hit enter, I will be returned with my 3. Now, the final string function I would like to show you is one that tells you how long a string is. And this one is called len for length. So if I type equals len with a left parenthesis, I'm only prompted for one argument here, and that is how long is the text in what cell? So I'm just going to click on Mississippi right here in cell E1 and close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see my len function being returned within 11, which is the number of characters in the word Mississippi. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction to some of the different substring functions that are available to you in Excel. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.